Welcome back to the Phantom Llama's Den, everyone. My name is Matt, and this is going to be the third installment in our AK Project series. If you haven't seen the first two videos in this series, I'll have them linked down in the description, and I'll even have them linked at the end of the video in the end screen stuff. Today we're doing just a couple little things. Obviously, I got the AK reassembled after doing the deep clean last video, and I also off camera started using my True Oil. This is the same stuff I use on my M1 Garand, and I started using it on just the wooden handguard, and it is actually looking a lot better already. I'm going to do this several times, and I'll add another coating of it today, and I'll put a picture here of what it looked like originally. So even after just one coating, this is looking a lot better. But the big project for today is actually going to be installing my new brace. This is a CNC Warrior brand brace. I got this off the internet. It is a brace, and you can see the Velcro here, and it attaches to your forearm. And because of the way things are in the US right now, and who knows what the ATF is gonna say about braces, I wanted to get something that was a brace, but if it's an SBR, I'm gonna want something that can function as a true stock. And the CNC Warrior brace is really nice because it's essentially just the folding. I guess I just spoiled that. This is a side folding brace. So this would be when it's collapsed down, and then you would just flip it back. It still keeps it classified as a pistol, but it still adds that extra point of contact, which will make this gun a lot more reliable. It'll be really cool. It'll really give the M92, my Zastava M92, that Krinkhoff style look that I'm going for. So I'm really excited to install this. Once I've installed the brace, I'm gonna do another layer, another coating of True Oil, and we'll see if that's gonna darken it up anymore. At worst, it's just gonna help better preserve it. So let's get to this real quick. So Logan called me out on my last video. He texted me after he watched it saying, "Dude, fix your wrenches." Apparently it bothers him that I don't have them all facing the same way. I didn't even realize it. I'm pretty OCD about a lot of things, but that's actually kind of funny. And it's really only... Okay, I'm not going to be able to unsee that. One second. I fixed it. I fixed my wrenches just for you, buddy. If you are looking to add a brace to your M92, there is something you'll have to watch out for, and this is going to be a small issue for me. This is not going to be just a simple bolt-on for me, because I have this M92 is one of the early models before they had added a sling mount to the back of the firearm. So what I'm going to actually have to do is drill a hole for the mounting hardware in the back of the gun. The way AKs are designed, there isn't anything back there. There is nothing back here. You have the trigger assembly here, but there's a good 2-3 inches here. 2.5. I'm not too worried about cutting through the metal and damaging here. I'm just gonna have to be careful. What I'm gonna do here is do a dry fitting here and make sure that's as flush as I really can get it. I thought I had a silver Sharpie, but apparently I don't. So that's okay, because this Sharpie will still show on the metal. If you're doing this, you'll need a 5/16 drill bit. That's the size of the bolt. And I'm just now realizing I would really benefit from having a vise on this workbench. Oh, the comment section is going to be so angry with me on this.
Sometime later.
Okay, there we have it. We have the hole drilled. Nothing went wrong. There were no catastrophic unexpected occurrences inside from drilling in. What I'm gonna do next is cold blue, just that ring that was cut. I'm gonna go ahead and put a thin coating of birchwood perma blue just along the outer rim and the inside there, just to coat what is now bare metal. Okay, so to save everyone else that might be doing this project a little bit of time, and if you're not the best at judging the size of Allen wrenches, I got really lucky there. It is a quarter, it's a quarter inch Allen wrench that the bolt uses. Get that in there. All right. Brace is installed. That's fantastic. That just makes this look so much better. And it really completes the look between the muzzle booster and the brace. All right, let's see how easy. Oh, that's not too bad at all. And it doesn't, I won't say it locks forward, but there is definitely some retention there. So it doesn't just flop down. So that's neat. One thing I want to point out about the CNC Warrior brace is when it comes to your door, it has a very thick oil, a very thick grease on it. It essentially smells like gear oil, what's in your differential in your car. If you know what that smells like, you can never forget it. I personally can't stand it. I know some people, Dad, that like the smell of gear oil, of differential oil. What I did, I just used some gun cleaner and some solvent to strip all of that grease out. That said, you need to replace it with something. What I've gone with is just the Lucas Extreme Duty Gun Grease. I use this on my M1. You want something that's pretty thick, pretty heavy duty. Otherwise, as I noticed, as soon as I stripped that grease off, the brace will seize up. You can get it working with WD-40 and maybe some CLP, but I would definitely recommend using heavy duty grease, maybe just something that doesn't smell as bad as the stuff that it came with. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put the bolt back in, and then we'll move on to putting another coating of True Oil on the handguard. You know, as I'm finishing up here, I think we're gonna roll a little side by side of the before and the after. This has turned out so well. I'm very pleased with how this has come together. Yeah, this project has actually turned out pretty well. Honestly, better than I expected it to. I didn't have any real hiccups. I'm sorry you're not gonna get to see it shoot in this video. I promised Steve that I'd do my very best to wait until he's available to take him back out to the range, and we'll go and shoot it for the first time since it's had all the work done on it. And because he really wants to see how it shoots. So I figure, we'll do that for part four of this, because let's be honest, I'm milking this one. But as far as my M92 pistol is concerned, this is absolutely fantastic. I love it. I can't wait to shoot it. I hope that you've enjoyed this series so far. Stay tuned for the fourth episode when we get it back out to the range. And please consider liking this video and commenting below with any suggestions, any other ideas you might have for this. Consider subscribing to the Phantom Llama's Den. We are going to have some genuinely awesome content on the channel in 2023. As always, thank you for watching this video. Please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon for notifications on future content. As always, don't take life too seriously and make it a great day. I love this thing.